Hi, my name is Grant Hobson. I work as a finance analyst. Today I'm going to talk you through some business maths calculations and ratios. How to calculate internal rate of return, or IRR. The internal rate of the return is basically where the net present value of the costs and the net present value of the benefits of an investment equals zero. The IRR is a commonly used tool for analysing investment decisions. Where we've got a positive favourable IRR, then it's deemed that the project should go ahead. Alternatively, if it's not favourable, then we wouldn't. We're going to run through a calculation now just to demonstrate how this works. So the equation for the internal rate of return is as shown above. Basically, there's several variables within the calculation. You see it's a lower rate and a higher rate. So what we do for the calculation is we take one NPV rate, and that outcome will generate a favourable return. We then want to take an alternate, or it'll generate a favourable or an adverse return. So then what we'll do if it's an, we'll then take another NPV rate, either increasing or decreasing, to get the opposite return. So we need, for the formula, we need one favourable and one adverse return. It'll become clear as we work through the example. Okay, so in this example, I'm saying that we're buying a machine for £160,000. It's given a 5-year life. The machine is going to save £40,000 per year, and it has a residual value of £20,000. So if you set up a table as below, as shown here, it'll help you work through the calculation. You'll need to have an understanding of present value, discount factors, etc. So if you don't have that, it's worth getting that understanding before doing this calculation. As you'll see, I've already got discount factors included in here. So what I'm saying is that in year zero, which is the point that we purchased the machine, I had a cash outflow, so this is my cash flow. In year zero, I had a cash outflow of £160,000. The present value of that cash flow is £160,000 because it's happened now. I then said for the next 5 years, I've had a consistent saving of £40,000 per year. So basically, I put £40,000 for years 1 to 5. And the present value of that next few years cash inflow is £151,640. So this discount factor, it's simply, it's your 40,000 times by your 3.791. In the final year, and then get the residual income from the, say, sale of this machine, so that's £20,000. That's just the 1 year income, so that in the tables is a factor of 0.621, which gives us 12,420. So you'll see it's simply 20,000 multiplied by that factor. So I'm saying here that I've got a present value of these cash flows of £4,060. So at 10%, I'm 4060, and I've said, as you can see below, so if we have a positive outcome, I then need to use a higher IRR, so a higher rate, for the second bit of the calculation, because obviously the IRR will be when it's zero. Alternatively, if it was negative, we need to use a lower rate for stage two. So having used 10% when calculating NPV in step one, I'm now going to use 12% to try and hopefully get a negative outcome down here. So we're putting the same cash outflow in year one, same £40,000 per year, and the same residual value of 20,000. Now you'll see that the present value, well, the discount factors have changed here, and that's obviously because we've gone up to a 12% rate. And you'll see that we've got a negative outcome of 4,460. So as we've now got a negative here and a positive here, I know that the internal rate of return will be at a point between 10% and 12%, because that's the only place where the NPV will be zero. So now basically what we need to do is take the elements from this data set and put them into the formula. So having decided that we need to find a rate between 10 and 12%, we now use the formula above and insert the data in there. So the formula, so we take 10, which is the lower rate. We then have the MPV at that lower rate divided by the MPV at the lower rate and the MPV at the higher rate. So it's simply 4060 divided by 4060 less 4460. So it's obviously 4060 plus 4460 times by the higher rate minus the lower rate. So times by 12 minus 10. So just to recap there, we've got the 10% rate at the lower rate. We then divide the MPV, the outcome 4060, by the sum of these two. So 4060 plus 4460 times by the 12% minus the 10%, so your higher rate minus your lower rate. Which generates a figure of 10.95. So at a percentage level, we'd say that the IRR is 11% and we'd therefore undertake the project.